Hello students, this is the second video of the chapter Black Beauty. In the first video we have seen how Black Beauty used to play with the other colts and used to bite and kick them, and how his mother called him and advised him to grow up as a gentle and good-natured horse. Now I will continue with the remaining explanation. I have never forgotten my mother's advice. Our master was very fond of my mother because she was wise and good. Her name was Duchess, but our master called her Pet. So Black Beauty says that he never forgot his mother's advice, and after that he became a good-natured horse. And his master was very fond of his mother because she was a very wise and good horse. Though her name was Duchess, his Duchess is the name of Black Beauty's mother, but the master called her Pet. Our master gave us good food, good lodging. Lodging means place to stay, and kind words. He spoke as kindly to us as he did to his little children. He was a good man. So Black Beauty's master was a very kind-hearted person who took care of them, and he gave them good food to eat, good and comfortable place to stay, and he treated the horses in the same way as he treated his. We all liked him very much, and my mother was devoted to him. When she saw him at the gate, she would neigh with joy. Neigh is here the sound of the horses, and trot up to him. He would pat and stroke her and say, "Well, old pet, how is your little colt today?" Then he would give me a piece of bread, which was very good. He often brought a carrot for my mother. All the horses would come to him, but I think we were his favorites. My mother always took him to town in a little gig. See, now look at this picture, children. Black Beauty is telling that whenever the master came, then Black Beauty's mother used to run to the gate, and she would neigh with joy and trot up to him, and he would pat her and give her a carrot to eat, and he always gave Black Beauty a piece of bread. And Black Beauty's mother always took the master to the town in the light gig. A gig is a small light carriage pulled. See, this is the picture of a gig. There was a ploughboy, Dick, who sometimes came into our field to pluck blackberries from the hedge. When we had eaten all he wanted, he would have what he called fun with the colts, throwing stones and sticks at them to make them gallop. The stones often hurt us. Now, a ploughboy means a boy who guides the animals drawing a plough. So Dick was a ploughboy who took care of these horses and also guided them when they were drawing a plough. But he was a very naughty fellow. He always came to the field and he plucked blackberries. Now, blackberries are small black fruit that grows on bushes. And when Dick used to eat the blackberries, what he used to do? He used to pick up stones and hit the horses. And the horses got hurt and they galloped from one place to another. Now, this Dick, he was so insensitive. It was just fun for him to hit the animals with stones and sticks, but he didn't realize that even they have feelings and they got hurt. So what happened? One day he was at his cruel game. Now what was the cruel game? Throwing stones at the horses. When the master came to the next field, as Dick did not know that he was being watched by the master, he continued throwing stones at us. The master jumped over the hedge in a snap and went up to Dick. "Bad boy," he scolded. "Bad boy to chase the colts. I shall not want you on my farm again." So one day when Dick was throwing stones at the horses, the master came and he saw Dick doing that cruel thing. And the master, he loved his horses very much, just like his own children. So immediately he came to Dick and told, "Bad boy, how insensitive of you to hit the animals like that." And he told him that you need not come to my farm again. The master sent Dick away so we never saw him again. Old Daniel, the man who looked after the horses, was told to look after us. Since he was just as kind and gentle as our master, we were comfortable and happy. So when the master is kind and gentle, he takes care of the animals. And so the animals also love their master. So just like the master, old Daniel also took care of the animals and he loved them. So with this, we come to the end of this chapter. Thank you, children.